Good day, my personal finance students, and welcome to the discussion of Lesson 6, which is investment and the different types of investment. Thank you for subscribing on my YouTube channel, and for those who haven't subscribed, please subscribe now. Investment or investing is a very important aspect of personal finance. We discuss about how to manage our money, how to budget. We discuss about savings. We discuss about credit. And of course, we must be able to know how to make our money grow, and that is through investing. So I have here some of the definitions of investment. So when we talk about investment, so it pertains to the different assets or properties or any financial or monetary assets that could able to realize income or profit. Or if you're going to look at its value is increasing over a period of time. And these assets or properties also are being used in the future to create wealth. So that will provide us income in the future, or any asset or properties that we had able to acquire and can be sold at a higher price in the future. So that will give us, of course, a profit. So if we are making an investment, so those investments are expected to increase our equity. So if you still remember our statement of financial position, so that will increase our equity, and investment will reduce our financial worries. But of course, investment will require sacrifices. So we have to sacrifice our current pleasures with the hope and expectations that the resources or the assets or the properties that we acquired will enhance in the future, or again, will create wealth. So, ganun naman talaga, diba? Kailangan nating magtiyaga para magkaroon ng nilaga. Kailangan nating may isuksok para meron tayong madukot. Then we have the investment portfolio. So, of course, if you will start investing, you will start on a small one, or that depends on your investable cash. You will start only with one investment, then you'll be having two investments with you, three investments with you. So, if you're going to have different assets or properties held as investment, that will be considered as your investment portfolio. So it is considered as investment portfolio kasi combination yan, or nandyan na lahat ng mga investment natin of different types. And we have the different evidences or documents for our investment. So there should be a supporting documents or evidence ng investment natin, or else hindi natin pwedeng sabihin na sa atin talaga yung investment na yan. So before you could create an investment portfolio, before you could invest, you should assess your cash. You should have an investable cash. Having cash with you is not enough in order for you to invest. So you have to go back to our lesson 4, which is money management. If you still remember our spending plan, our budget, our income and expense. So you have to determine the expenses of your family. So you have to set aside at least 3 to 6 months of the household or family expenses. You have to set it aside first, and any amount in excess of that will be considered as your investable cash. Kasi hindi rin naman maganda na may investment ka pero ang dami mong unsettled na liabilities. May investment ka nga pero wala namang kinakain yung pamilya mo. May investment ka nga, pero palagi kang nangungutang kasi wala ka ng magastos para sa pamilya mo, diba? So, That means you have to prioritize first the needs of your family. So you have to determine first the needs of your family, the expenses of your family. Let us say the expenses of your family is 10,000 a month, and you have to multiply it by 3. Pero ngayon makikita natin, due to pandemic, most probably everything is uncertain. Mas maganda na 10,000 times 6 na, you have to set aside 60,000 pesos with you. At kung may excess cash ka, iyon pa lang ang pwede nating pang-invest. So we have to make the expenses for our family safe first before investing. Yung excess amount after setting aside the expenses intended for 6 months, iyon lang ang pwede nating ipang-invest. Another thing to consider before investing is your liquidity buffer. So remember that. So before investing, you must have your investable cash, and investable cash could be derived by having an excess after setting aside all the money you need for an average from 3 to 6 months, or ang advice nga ng mga financial experts ngayon, itabi mo yung good for 6 months or even good for 1 year na para safe talaga yung expenses ng family mo. And then other than that, because of the different uncertainties nowadays, we have to set aside again an amount as our liquidity buffer so that in case of unexpected cash requirements, in case of emergencies, let us say accident, hospitalization, medical expenses, kung wala naman tayong mga medical insurance, wala tayong ibang pagkukuhanan yan, meron tayong mga hindi inaasahan na biglang naging gastos, minsan dumarating yan na hindi natin inaasahan. So, iyan muna ang dapat nating pagtuunan din ng pansin, or we have to set aside funds for that, and that will serve as our liquidity buffer. So kung safe na yung pangangailangan ng family natin, which is good for 3 or 6 or even good for 1 year, and then we have set aside amount as our liquidity buffer, any amount in excess for that, that will be considered as our investable cash. And with that, we are now ready for investment. I have here the different types of investments which are common and very familiar with us. So, ito yung mga list natin. Tignan natin. So, maybe, of course, yung mga bank accounts, we are familiar with that. Maybe treasury bills and commercial papers, bago sa inyo. Bonds, stocks, yan, naririnig na natin, and the rest that I have here. So, we're going to discuss them one by one. But other than this, napakarami pang investment na pwede nating ma-avail in the financial market. And there are different financial instruments or contracts or documents that we could acquire. And those investment, as long as it provides us income, it appreciates in value, it could be sold at a higher price in the future, that will be considered as our investment. In investing, these two are partners, return and risk. Every investment has a presence of risk. But not all investment will guarantee us a return. Because of the presence of risk, chances are we will win, or we will have an income, or we will have loss. So chances that there will be unfavorable event that will occur, and that will affect our investment, and that will affect also our return. So different investment has different types of risk. So there are low risk investment, there are a medium or moderate risk investment, and there are also high risk investment. And as said by financial experts, the higher the risk involved, the higher is the return. So if you are a risk taker, if you are very much willing to take the risk, So chances are you're going to have a higher return on the future. Since I've mentioned that every investment has the presence of risk, so ano ba itong mga risks na ito na pwede natin kaharapin sa isang investment? So let us say you are interested in investing in real properties, because investing in real properties does not require so much skills. May puhunan ka lang na pambili ng lupa, bahay at lupa, then pag tumaas ang presyo, ibenta mo, it's considered as your investment. But what are the risks involved sa mga real properties? Okay, so in example, yung subdivision na kung saan nandun yung bahay at lupa na binili mo, na gusto mong ibenta din someday na pag tumaas na yung price, eh nagkaroon ng landslide kasi palaging umuulan, palaging bumabagyo. So, iyon yung risk involved, no? Doon, yung mga calamities na pwedeng tumama sa isang lugar na pwedeng makaapekto sa ating mga real properties. Okay, then let us say yung mga investment natin in agriculture. Nag-invest tayo sa mga alagang hayop. Alam naman natin na meron tayong mga tinatawag na mga foot and mouth disease. Meron tayong mga kung ano-anong klase na peste or sakit sa mga hayop natin na inaalagaan. And then pagdating naman sa mga iba't ibang halaman or sa mga gulay, sa mga puno, pag dumating ang bagyo, nasisira yung mga pananim natin. Nandiyan din yung mga peste, nasisira. Nandiyan yung tagtuyot, nandiyan yung baha na pwedeng makaapekto sa mga investment natin in agriculture, in animal production, or in poultry. So, maraming investment na present sa ating financial market, but bawat investment, there will be presence of risk. So, let us say you will invest in stocks na tinatawag natin, mga ownership sa mga corporation na yan. So, chances are the corporation will become profitable or not. Of course, if the corporation incurred losses, that will affect our shares of stock. Bababa yung value ng shares natin, and most probably, of course, if it's not profitable, it will not declare dividends. So, yun yung risk na involved. And then, sa mga corporation na mga nag-i-issue ng bonds, so there are chances na yung mga liabilities nila hindi na nila mabayaran. So kung tayo ay bumili ng bonds coming from them, so most probably will not going to have a return on our investment. So different types of investment has the presence of risk. So let us say yung mga precious metals natin, yung mga golds natin na yan na nag-appreciate ng value. But alam natin na prone siya into theft, di ba? Manakaw yung mga asset natin na yan. So that's the risk involved. Kaya nga, kapag ganyan yung mga asset natin, ang nangyayari, dinedeposit yan sa mga safety vault ng mga banking or ng mga financial institutions for it to make safe. And then yung mga uso ngayon ng mga investment online through electronic money, na ang nangyayari karaniwan ay nai-scam tayo. So yun yung presence ng risk, no? And then meron tayong mga hackers, meron tayong mga scammers na pwedeng mag-cause ng problem sa mga investment natin. So, iyon yung mga kailangan nating pag-aralan at kailangan nating gumawa ng mga mitigating moves or steps in order to prevent yung mga ganyang klaseng risk if kaya naman natin. Since we have the presence of risk on the different types of investment that we could able to have, so one remedy for that is to diversify our investment. So when we say diversification of investment, we're going to spread our investable funds. We should not concentrate on one type of investment. So let us say, tumama ka sa loto, binili mo lahat ng bahay at lupa sa isang subdivision lang. O, anong nangyari? Bumagyo, walang tigil ang ulan, bumaha, gumuho yung subdivision na yon. So wala na lahat ang investment mo. So if you are very much interested sa investment in real properties, mag-diversify ka. Ibig sabihin, kung gusto mo talaga ng bahay at lupa or lupa, iba't ibang lugar sa Pilipinas or even outside the country ang piliin natin. That is a form of diversification. And another one, you should acquire different types of assets or properties. Para, sabi nga, no, do not put all your eggs in one basket. So you have to spread your investment. So kung meron kang 1,000,000 piso at gusto mo lang na safe siya, nasa banko lang, so ang gawin mo, 500,000 sa isang banko, 500,000 sa isang banko. Bakit kailangan mo pang hatiin? Kasi yung insurance, no, yung PDIC insurance ng ating mga savings deposit or yung mga account deposit natin sa banko is secured up to 500,000 pesos only. Kasi kung 1 million pesos ang pera mo sa banko at na-bankrupt yung banko na yan, you could just have half of it dahil hanggang 500,000 lang ang kanyang insurance. So I have here an example of what Juan de la Cruz had did on his investment portfolio, 5 million. Nasa real properties, then 3 million sa shares of stocks, then 2 million nasa treasury bills, and then 5 million for time deposit. So this is how he diversified his investment. So different types of investment. And then for Joanna de la Cruz, this is how she diversified her investment. So gusto lang ni Joanna ay shares of stocks, pero hindi siya nag-concentrate sa isang industry. So ang ginawa niya, yung 2.5 million niya, or an average of 10 million ni Joanna, 2.5 million for each company. So sa Microsoft, sa General Electric, sa Pfizer, sa Coca-Cola. So the diversification made by Joanna, when it comes to shares of stock, she chooses different companies coming from different industries. So Microsoft is related to IT, then General Electric sa mga appliances natin, then we have Pfizer for laboratory or medicines, and then we have Coca-Cola for beverages. So ganyan ang sinasabi natin pagdating sa diversification. So kung gusto natin ng isang type of investment, which is shares of stock, huwag tayong mag-concentrate lang sa isang industry. So let us say gusto mo oil products lang. Nag-invest tayo sa Shell, sa Petron, sa Total, sa Unioil, sa Caltex. So nung year 2020, ayan, bumagsak ang shares ng mga oil companies dahil humina yung consumption ng oil products. So, bumaba, apektado lahat ng investment natin dahil nag-concentrate lang tayo sa isang industry. So, ang advice sa atin ng mga financial expert, we might as well spread our investment. Kung gusto mong mag-concentrate sa shares of stock, you have to choose companies from different types of industries. Para pag bumagsak man yung isang industry, meron pa rin tayong fallback. So, hindi apektado yung iba nating shares of stocks. So, common sa atin yung pag-open ng savings account in a bank. So, this one is a form of investment but it's will give you a very, very, very minimal, a very, very low return. So, it's just a matter of, in a year, an average of 0.5, no, interest per annum, na mas mababa pa nga ngayon sa ibang bangko, no, per annum na yun. So 0.5%, so that will be 0.005 pa So you could just compute how much yung magiging interest natin. Then may mga bank service charge pa. And you could have the interest if you will fall within the required maintaining balance pa din ng mga banko. Kapag nag-below the maintaining balance ka, wala ka ng interest, may mga charges pa. Pero for safekeeping ng money natin, talagang advisable naman yung mga savings account natin. Yung availability ng pera natin, lalo ngayon may internet, may mobile banking, may ATM, guaranteed yan in a savings account. But talking of savings account as an investment, again, that will give you a very, 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 very minimal return. So another account being offered by a bank is a checking account. But take note of this, this one is not a form of investment. So huwag kayong malilito na we're talking about investment tapos nasama ko rito yung checking account. Kasi nga, nadaanan natin itong mga accounts sa banko, then they are offering yan, a time deposit, savings account, and checking account. But checking account is not a form of investment. So, for safety lang din ang pera natin, you can easily withdraw your money by issuing checks. So, ang kaibahan sa savings account natin, we could withdraw it over the counter, we could withdraw it online through ATM kung meron tayong card, but checking account could be withdrawn only by issuing checks. Without the checks, hindi natin may encash yung pera natin under our checking account. It is also called as demand accounts and current accounts. So mostly, these are being used for household purposes kapag merong mga kailangang bayaran through the use of checks. Mostly kasi yung mga housing loan, mga car loan, nire-require nila ay PDC or post-dated checks. Kaya nag-open ng checking account ang mga private individuals. Then for businesses naman, mas convenient no, to pay expenses and liabilities through checks. Kasi you could keep track dun sa mga checks na ini-issue natin. Again, this is not a form of investment because checking account is non-interest bearing. May required maintaining balance din yan. Now, if you fall below the maintaining balance, magkakaroon din tayo ng bank service charge. Pero minsan, as marketing strategies, may mga banko na nag-offer ng parang combination siya ng savings and checking account. Mas mataas ang required maintaining balance. At yung checking account na yon nag-earn ng interest. So you can inquire it from a bank. But basically, a checking account is not a form of investment if it doesn't give you any amount of interest. Another account being offered by a bank is time deposit. So this one will give us a higher income compared to a savings account, but this will require a higher amount of deposit and it will require you to make your money stay on a bank for a certain period of time, minimum of 3 months yung ino-offer ng ibang banko. So it's good to hear kung makakita tayo ng banko na nag-offer ng mga 1 month time deposit. So the longer your money stay on the bank, of course, the higher will be the interest. At meron din silang mga pinoprovide na mga scheme, no? Na meron silang mga amount na pinapapili tayo kung magkano yung investment na gusto natin, magkano yung time deposit na kaya natin, at nakalagay doon yung corresponding rate of interest. Of course, the higher the time deposit, the amount of time deposit, the higher will be the interest. And the longer your money will stay on the bank, the higher will be the interest. So what the difference between the time deposit and savings account, aside from the interest, no, the amount of interest or the percentage of interest being given, is that for time deposit, your money is restricted. Kaya nga time deposit, you have to wait for the term before you could able to withdraw your money. Unlike for a savings account, Your money is available at any time you want. That ends our video for investment. So make sure to attend our online class for additional discussion on investment. So there will be no written activities because we're going to have our online activities during our online classes. And another one, of course, advance notice. So make sure that you are preparing your reflection papers for your final requirements.